We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Boston Red Sox and the Toronto Blue Jays. And here's Jose Peraza, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The 1-2.
At the ball.
Sliced hard on the ground, fielded cleanly, and there's one gone to begin the evening. So one away here with the bases empty, and that brings up the outfielder Alex Verdugo.
Verdugo.
Bounce to first. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Here's J.D. Martinez.
J.D. Martinez.
The 3-1 pitch. And we'll have the first base runner of the ball game here as that misses, and it's a two-out walk. Here's Xander Bogaerts now. A couple of hits for him in four trips in yesterday's game. Swing and a ground ball to third. Scooped up, and as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Now batting, Rowdy Tellez. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Strike two as the fastball is let go. And he looks at a cold strike three as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one. So the base is empty here with one away, and that brings up the big bat of Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Line to the right side, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. At the plate now, Mortis Gurriel, fouled away. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. And it's fouled away. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's four.
And that's through for a hit. So now to the plate, to Oscar Hernandez. Bullet back up the middle. Pilar is there, two gone. So it's first and second with two men gone. And in the bat next, the legacy, Bo Bichette. Ah, gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2.
I wouldn't be surprised if he uses aggressiveness against him right here. You're going to get a swing out.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Rafael Devers the next to bat, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. The 3-2 pitch. Swing, and he pops him up. Coming in is Hernandez, but this will land untouched. Payoff pitch one more time. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up a man who's a human highlight reel defensively, Kevin Pillar. Slider is in there, and now it's 1-2. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Digging in now, Christian Vasquez will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. 1-2 to the Red Sox catcher. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 3-2 one more time. And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. So digging in now, Rendell Gritcher. The 3-1 pitch. Hit down the third baseline. But a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. This is hit high and deep out to left. Back goes Martinez. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Into the box now, Reese McGuire, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Bottom of the second here with no score. Had nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1. Looked like he got fooled on the speed there. 2-2. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count. 3-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Stepping in, Billy McKinney. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Top of the third set to get underway. Striding forward now is the DH, Michael Chavis. The 1-2. A shot down the first baseline. A dive, but it's off his glove. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. So striding forward now, Mitch Moreland. He'll get to take his first cuts here. The 2-1 home. To right field and deep. Look at this thing go. And gone up into the second deck. Into the box now, Jose Peraza. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. To two balls and two strikes now. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Full count to Jose Peraza. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. This is foul right side. Grounded back up the middle. And there's out number two. Digging in, Alex Verdugo. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. On the ground to third. Reined in. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Next to bat for Toronto, Kevin Biggio. Ready to deliver the 1-2. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Number 44.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Rowdy Tellez. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
How about it?
So he sets number him down swinging. Rowdy Tellez becomes out number two this inning. And he got another one here. He strikes out the side. He set down five in a row via the punch out, and the inning is over. All set for the start of the fourth. Into the box now, J.D. Martinez reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. Called strike two as he locks him up there.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through four, five, and six right here.
And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Here it comes. Drilled down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but he gets by the glove down the line.
Now batter, third baseman, Rafael Devers.
Into the box, Rafael Devers. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around it?
Next up for the Red Sox, Kevin Pillar, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Waiting on it is Hernandez. And he makes the catch for the second out. Digging in for his second at bat, Christian Vasquez. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Line drive to left. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Stepping in for the Jays, Lourdes Gurriel. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. The 1-1 home. Is strike two swinging.
Man, this has been a game filled of a lot of swings and misses. Not very many confident swings, and this team up there, they'd swing at a butterfly right now if it flew in front of the plate. Lots of swings, lots of misses, a lot of ugly at-bats for this team right now.
The 1-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Martinez has a read on it. One away. So one away here with the bases empty. And striding into the plate next will be Teoscar Hernandez. 2-2. High in the air out to center field. Pillar's there. And that's the second out of the inning. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Bo Bichette, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position.
Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. So here's Michael Chavis now. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. The 1-1.
Count is 2-1. Three balls.
It's been a great job so far by the 8-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Three balls and two strikes to the DH for the Red Sox. Back up the middle. He's got it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Now at the plate, Mitch Moreland. He went deep in his first at bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Now here it comes. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth. So the Red Sox lineup turns over, and to the plate, Jose Peraza. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Takes this the other way to right, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So the two out base hit in the top of the inning is still alive. Here's a look over to first, and he's back in standing. Peraza leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. To the plate now, Alex Verdugo. Outside, 2-1. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor and he's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Here's a bouncing ball and a chance for Gurriel. It's short. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Randall Grichuk at the plate now. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Another 1-2 delivery. Misses, ball two. Hit sharply on the ground, and that finds its way through for a base hit. In now, Reese McGuire. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Verdugo looks up, and they take the lead. It's gone. Ryan Weber is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. At the plate now, Billy McKinney. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. The 2-2 one more time. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Three balls and two strikes to the Blue Jays center fielder.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher.
And now this ball's in the air to deep right field. But he's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first down.
The batter, number eight.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Kevin Biggio. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Well hit to right, but a foul ball. Another full count offering on its way. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Oh, and he can't come up with it. So a runner at first with one man gone, and that'll bring up Rowdy Tellez. The 2-1. Line drive, that's a base hit into the right center field gap. This'll kick up against the wall now. Biggio rounds the corner and is headed home. He comes across to score. As they extend the lead a bit, it's now a 3-1 game.
Now batting. Number 27.
So now to the plate, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now. On, he pops it up, drifting just beyond the infield. Peraza ranges back, and he has it for out number two. Now at the plate, Lourdes Gurriel, runner in scoring position with two gone. Three runs already home here. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Grounder down the line at third. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball four. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Teoscar Hernandez. 0-for-2 for him to this point.
Teoscar Hernandez.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. Top half of the sixth about to get started. Coming to the plate now, J.D. Martinez. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot. Has to put the ball in play.
Hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
The batter, number two, Xander Bogaerts.
Stepping in now, Xander Bogaerts. All even now, 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Right fielder is on the run. He makes the play. Runner tags and heads for third. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Digging in once again, Rafael Devers. It was a walk in his last trip. Bouncer to the left side. A throw to the plate, and he's out at the plate as they cut him down trying to score. Digging in, Kevin Pillar. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. A 1-1. One run, four hits, and one error on the Boston line score. Bouncer to the left side. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Next will be the designated hitter, Bo Bichette. He'll get things started here in the second half of the sixth. And it's a full count, 3-2 to the Blue Jays DH. Fly ball out toward right field. Verdugo waits on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. One out now in the Toronto sixth inning. And the big right-handed bat of Randall Grichuk saunters into the batter's box next. Three balls and a strike to count to Randall Grichuk. Swing and a ball line hard towards short. And that's into the outfield for a one-out hit. He's around first, heading for two.
Now back, number 10.
At the plate, Reese McGuire. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. And that misses 2-2. Now a swing and a miss. Maybe even a foul tip, but it's held onto behind the plate for out number two. So a runner at second. Two down now. And in to hit next, the speedy Billy McKinney. Fouled off. Well off the plate with the change of pace. That's ball two. Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. seventh inning ready to roll. Ready once again, Christian Vasquez.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
And a perfect start to the seventh, as this should be extra bases. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Now back, designated hitter, Michael Chavis.
To the plate now, Michael Chavis. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Takes this the other way to right. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Mitch Moreland will be his first assignment, and he's got a tough spot here with the runner at third and only one gone. A 1-1. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he misses ball four, so he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing, 3-1 our score. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? One there. On the first, it's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. Darwin's and Hernandez gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 53.
Last half of the seventh here. Riding in once again, Kevin Biggio. 0-for-2 of the runs scored so far. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Line shot to first, and there's one away.
Now back.
Rowdy Tellez the next 24. To bat. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Strike two as the hanging slider was let go. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2. And the payoff pitch. Hit hard to the right side, but foul. And he fouls this one off. Still three balls and two strikes. The eighth pitch of the at-bat. Lifted down the line in left. And they can't run it down. Three runs, six hits. And no errors in the game for Toronto. Out in front as he rolls over it to second. Fielded cleanly. On to Moreland, and that's in time for the second out. Standing in, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 1-1 home. Makes him swing and miss on a ball out of the zone for strike two. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him. Anthony Bass is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. And the next up will be Alex Verdugo. Lee lifted the other way down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The 3-2 pitch to third, scooped up. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. And that'll bring up J.D. Martinez. In prior meetings against Anthony Bass, just a couple of matchups, no hits in 2 at-bats. Bouncer to the left side. And that's the second out. So here's the Boston cleanup hitter, Xander Bogaerts. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Hard hit ball to second, reined in. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Heath Hembree is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 37.
At the plate, Lourdes Gurriel. He singled earlier, making him 1-for-2 to this point. The 2-1. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Teoscar Hernandez.
Teoscar.
The 1-2. Popped up. Under it is Bogaerts, and there are 2 away now. Coming forward now, the Toronto designated hitter, Bo Bichette. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Back goes Martinez. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Ken Giles comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the 9th.
Number 51.
Set to start the 9th in this one, striding in for Boston, Rafael Devers. He's hitless in his 2 at-bats so far.
Looking for base runners here as they're down 2 playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
2-2 the count. Popped up. Guerrero has a play. 1 out. Coming to the plate now, Kevin Pillar. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Now the 2-1. Fouled away. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, 2 away. In now, Christian Vasquez. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the 9th. And this will be a called strike 2. And trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight.
Someone on this offense needs to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and start the line moving again.
Popped him up. Biggio calls for it. Makes the catch. And that's the ball game.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
Tonight's ball game comes to a close, 3-1 the final. The Blue Jays used a nice 5th inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Ryan Borucki gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Marcus Walden was only able to work 4 innings as he takes the loss. Ken Giles closes the door for the save, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Fans are finalized for tonight. First for the victorious Blue Jays. 3 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Red Sox, 1 run, 5 hits, 1 error. They left 7 men on base. time of the ball game, 2 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.